Hi, Cody, and welcome to Southeast Asia and Singapore. I work for Yahoo, and I have two questions to ask you on behalf of the Yahoo Answers community. The first question is, what's the most valuable lesson you've learned in life ever since you became a global icon? And the second one is, with fame and fortune comes great sacrifice. Is there ever a day or a single moment that you regret what you've become, or maybe because you missed out on something?
I think both questions, I think there's the same answer. It's, you know, I've been very, very fortunate to be in this position. And, you know, when you're in this position, the lesson that I've learned is to be able to take the blessings that you have and to help facilitate other opportunities for others, whether it's youth or whether it's people who are older or I have dreams. To try to help facilitate that. That's why I've become significantly more open with my preparation and charitable causes that I support, just to try to help others, to try to guide others. And that's the lesson that I've learned. And two, that's what's really important to me, being in this position. I don't regret it one second.
Hi, Cody. I hope I'm not going to annoy you, but you know, of all the points you've scored, 61, 81, maybe it's just that you also miss a lot. I just want to know, what goes through your mind, you know, when you miss and you keep coming back, you know, and keep trying?
Just keep trying. You can't win a fight if you don't fight. You know what I mean? And that's always been my mentality. I've trained really long, and there have been times where I've just had miserable games. It's awful. You know, like 5 for 30 shooting. I mean, just terrible stuff. You know, and after the game, you want to have a sense of humor too, and I do. And you know, 5 for 30, it's like, that's really, you know, keep going, but really something, right? You know, it's just one of those things that you just kind of roll with, and you do it, and you try to shake it off, and you come back the next game and play better.
You're constantly under the spotlight wherever you go, right? You know, anywhere in the world. Do you like such kind of attention? How do you cope with it?
You know, I really don't like being in front of the camera. I really don't. I try to ignore the cameras while we're talking. And I love on the basketball court. That's like putting a fish in the water. that part of it. So, yeah, I mean, I've kind of just grown accustomed to it. It's not something that came natural to me.
As a LA native myself, lifelong Laker fan, I'm very excited about the prospect of you and the Lakers taking on Shaq, LeBron, the Cavs, the Titans. Like a big clash, the Titans. So, you know. And so I know it's a ways away. You know, you still have to go through the regular season of the playoffs. But have you thought at all about that? What that finals would be like?
It'd be crazy, you know, it's just a hoopla that surrounds it, and all the stories that could come out of it. Everyone has stories for days and days and days and days. But you know, for us as players, if that matchup is to happen, we have to take it one day at a time. We can't get caught up in us being in the finals or it being a given that we're going to be in the finals. We have to take care of our business. But that being said, it would be heck of a show.
Hi, Robin. Going forward to next season, Phil Jackson may be coaching a little less. What are your thoughts about Cavaliers taking a few games?
You said he's coaching less.
It's health and everything. You may be coaching less away games.
Man, Phil likes messing with you guys, man. he'll be there. He's extremely, extremely competitive. Extremely competitive, so you know he won't coach 2 games and then sit out 4 or 5. He's not doing that in a million years. He'll be there all the time unless he has a doctor's appointment that he needs to get to. But he'll be there.